Let's learn API Connect. Today, I will show you how to generate JWT tokens in API Connect. First, we log in to IBM Cloud Console. From Cloud Console, select your provision Cloud Foundry service of API Connect. Using the draft view of API Connect, I test an existing API which has a map policy. Map policy creates a hard-coded JSON output as shown on screen. Using the default settings, I create JWT token and store that into a variable called var_JWT. Claims and other parameters used in payload of JWT are pulled in from runtime variable, which should be null in our case. I then set the JWT token in the output JSON string, output JSON structure, for me to visually verify the results. Single quotes are used for string literals. Variables are written as shown on screen. When I tested JWT changes that I made to my API, I get status code -1. It complains of CORS. That could be an incorrect direction that we investigate. I then test the same API with curl command. Here I get to see the actual response of HTTP code 500. It says JWT generate failed. It was not a CORS issue at all. Let's go fix this now. I first need JSON web key or JWK. I use mkjwk.org website to create one as shown on screen. I can now set that string into a variable called hs256 hyphen key to be used later in JWT generate policy. We have to pass claims using HTTP request headers. If you do not do that, then you will face 500 HTTP code JWT generate failed error. Our test is successful. We have generated a JWT token in APIC. Results are mapped into a JSON object as shown on screen. Demo code that you saw in today's video and all other API source code from my video YouTube videos are available at my GitHub repo, link in description. While writing your code, you might face many issues. Use a debug mode with API Connect testing utility to gather more information on why your code might be failing. What did we learn today? We learned how to use a set variable policy to define HS256 JSON string. Then we used JWT generate policy to create a token. Later, we used a map policy to create output JSON structure. Do you gather debug information on your API from Data Power Gateway? Or do you use activity logs? Reply in comments.